Andy House would like to introduce the story, Ghost of the Woman. Chapter 1, Fateful Meeting in the Night. Khang arrived in the late afternoon. The summer rain suddenly fell and made the road slippery. After walking for a while, he had to take off his western shoes, digging his toes into the mud. At first, he was a little frowning because his feet touched the sharp pebbles, but the scenery around him immersed in his light. The rain triggered the cool, quiet appearance of this suburb. On both sides of the road are green trees. Sometimes there are fruit trees full of fruit. Wild flowers climbing up the road blooming brilliantly. He did not know what flower it was. A light purple flower with delicate wings. A green vine's like the veins on a person's wrist. Wrapped tightly around everything it met. On the tree branch there is a sound of birds chirping. He happily whistles in response. Feeling all the hardships on the journey here seem to disappear. The house that appeared before Khang was exactly as the hostess described. The wooden house was built in the old style, with tiled roof and tile roof, which turned green moss color over time. The wall is the same, every patch of moss and mold. Green ivy wires crawling all over the place, like increasing the ancient look of the house. Khang put his hand on the sweat on his forehead, looked around and around. The sun was about to fade. Check the key into the lock. The lock is rusty. Wet because there is no longer a person. The heavy wooden door opened and hissed. The smell of mold and smell entered Kang's nose. In the dim light, Khang tried to find the electric switch. After a groping, the light is also turned on. The golden light from the old light bulb covered the spider web, but it made the room warmer. After more than half an hour of running around, he also found a place to store his luggage and packed a sleeping area tonight. After all that, he was also tired. Luckily, there were some cakes he bought on the way here to eat temporarily to help with hunger. Khang took the chair out and sat in front of the house, breathing in air and at ease eating. At this time, the darkness had sneaked into the trees. Soon, half of the night will cover everything. The rainy scene here was gloomy, tingling with insects to make noise, lurking in the clattering frogs, making him even more sad. He stood up and took a deep breath. Suddenly, a cold wind blew from the back, causing him to shudder. The door hissed loudly. It was dark outside. The house has three very spacious rooms. In addition to the front main hall, the two smaller compartments are adjacent to each other. Khang found that the middle space was full of necessary items, such as a bed, and the closet was cool to sleep. The last compartment was carefully locked, but the old wooden door was no longer certain. He dropped his eyes and looked inside to see that the inside was dark and dimly placed in the middle of the room. A large table was placed. He found it strange that the landlady didn't give him the key to this room.
"Never mind,"
he told himself.
"It's quite tiring today anyway. Tomorrow, find a way to open the door."
He arranged his luggage quickly and went to lie down. The fatigue of a long trip should have caused him to fall asleep, but he kept on restless. For some reason, he had a hunch that there was something strange about this house. The house is old but still quite beautiful and solid. The garden is spacious, yet the landlady sells at a cheap price. Is he lucky? Being dreamed. When he looked back, the clock was to midnight. He was about to take a nap. Suddenly, in the night, there's a sound. What's the noise? He listened attentively. The noise suddenly stopped. He thought he heard wrongly when suddenly the noise came up, becoming clearer and clearer. In the late night, this time all fell silent like a sheet. There was only that sound, sounding like a claw of nails against a wooden wall. Khang got up and woke up. The sound came from the other side of the wall, in the locked room. He walked to his ear against the wall. Suddenly, a shrill scream sounded like tearing at his eardrums. He was dizzy. Khang staggered with his hands and walked to the outside. His feet suddenly stepped on something viscous. He lowered his head to look. He screamed in panic. "It is blood." Blood flowed from the corpse of a long-haired girl, lying sprawled on the floor. Her face was bloody and her eyes were wide open and stared at the ceiling. Kang's heart stopped beating in terror. He screamed in panic. Khang got up and gasped. Sweat broke out like a wet bath. He looked around. It turned out that he had just dreamed. It was morning. But the dream is real. His heart was pounding. Fear still. This is the first time he dreamed of such a scary nightmare.
Could it be because I was so tired then I had that dream? Or...
he told himself.